beautiful summer night in Southern California from Dodger Stadium. Tonight we begin a new homestand with the first of three between the San Francisco Giants and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Buster and Adrian go at it head-to-head next on the show. Number 18 will be on the mound for the series opener. EK, what's the word on him?
Well, guys, you can see right there, he's getting close to that 200 strikeout number. Throwing the ball extremely well, missing a lot of bases.
Denard Span heads for the batter's box, and we are just about ready for some evening baseball.
Center fielder, Denard Span.
First of three here on this Tuesday night as the game's first offering is taken for strike one. Eric, you look at your former employers, the Dodgers, as they enter play here tonight. All you can really say is they've been on one heck of a run.
And the even better news for them is that they've got their ace going here tonight. So you have to figure that all signs are pointing toward another victory here.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Hot shot on the ground is short. Oh, and it eats him up a bit.
No, he's safe.
Oh, you talk about being comfortable at the plate. That's the way he's feeling it right now. Nine straight games with that base hit now.
Joe Panic.
Striding into the box, Joe Panic. He'll get to take his first cuts here. First pitch of the at-bat. Swing and a line drive, but this will be foul. Here's the 0-1. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And he's retired here, one away. And here's how the visiting San Francisco Giants line up in this one. Eric, who should we keep an eye on?
Yeah, one guy I'm a little worried about is Brandon Crawford. He's hitting near the Mendoza line in his last 10 ball games and really having trouble getting anything positive going at the plate.
Buster Posey will get his first opportunity here, and as you can see, he's got that average up over the 290 mark to begin play.
Well, he's been hitting really well over his last 10 games or so, and he's someone to watch out for in this one.
And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
Oh, and that's a good fastball right there. He might have been thinking about protecting against that sinker.
Runner at first here, one man out. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. Looks like he employed the slide step on that last pitch.
Well, maybe you see a little cat and mouse game going between the pitcher and the runner right now. We'll see who wins this duel.
Here's a high pop-up calling for it. Gonzalez. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning. And with a quick breather here, let's look at how the Dodgers align on defense. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, guys, Corey Seager may not have your prototypical shortstop body, but he's proved he can handle the position. Standing at 6'4", a lot of people have felt like he might be too big, but he's proven everybody wrong and done a great job up to this point.
Brandon Belt is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. Is that really the spot you want to be messing with here?
Shouldn't be. That's a danger zone if you ask me.
The 0-1 pitch. Span runs. Pitch is a called strike. The throw. And he'll be tagged out at second base. Trying to get into scoring position, but instead the inning is over. Giants are down quietly. It's the Giants nothing. Dodgers coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on The Show. Chris Heston gets the call for game one of the series. Eric, any thoughts?
Well, guys, if you take a look at that whip, you can see he's been struggling all year long. A lot of base runners.
Kike Hernandez comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Leading off for the Dodgers, center fielder, Kike Hernandez.
He'll start him with a breaking ball. Too low that time. It's ball one. Ike, you look at the Giants as they begin play here tonight. They come in looking to make it two in a row as they were winners last time out.
And they've gotten that overall record back to 500 with their most recent win, but they've got a ways to go before they're back in this thing. So they'll need to keep it going right here.
In for a strike, it's 1-1. Figure we'll probably see a heavy dose of that sinker here tonight.
It's really a pitch you'll lean on, especially when he needs that ground ball. But even in situations like this where he's just trying to get ahead.
Swing and a little tapper, but it gets foul. Line hard toward right center. And this inning starts with a solid base hit.
So far, so good. They get a scoreless top of the first and now a leadoff single to start things in their half.
Howie Kendrick will stand in, 1-for-4 with a double in yesterday's ball game.
Well, this guy's hitting over 300 on the year now, and he had a good performance yesterday as well.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Inside corner, a ball and a strike.
A lot of people think that pitch will burn straight down, but it will work back a little bit towards righties, like that one did right there.
Nobody out, runner on first. Runner goes for second. Sent toward first. In there, a base hit. And now they'll have runners at the corners to start off the inning.
Oh, my goodness. This guy is really starting to heat up now. That's eight straight games with a base hit. He's been fun to watch.
Corey Seager will stand in. Currently eighth in the National League in hitting to enter play.
And he's right up there among the RBI leaders, too. So he's dangerous with runners on base.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Now a 58-foot curveball that misses for a ball.
And this is all about having faith in your catcher that he's going to block that pitch, as well he should. He's one of the best around when it comes to smothering balls in the dirt.
This is hit high in the air out toward left center. On the move is Span. He's there to make the catch, and here comes the runner from third as this should get him on the board. And they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score.
Well, they were looking for at least a sack fly here. Fortunately for them, they had the right man for the job at the plate. So nice work to come through and drive home an important run.
Justin Turner will stand in, and as you take a look at the splits there, he's actually a better hitter against right-handed pitching this season. Oh, fires a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is James Kingsley.
Well, Kingsley's a pretty fair umpire. Sometimes a pitcher will get a call in the corners, but he rarely has people barking at him about a strike zone.
Throw over to the bag. And a dive, but he's back in.
Just checking.
And again a throw. Oh, and it froze him, and they got him.
This is all about quickness with the right-handed pitcher on the mound. Here, they catch him in between steps at time, and the result is an easy pickoff.
Two out, nobody on. And a strike to even the count. One and one. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. To two balls and two strikes now. Bases are empty here with two men out. Hit in the air out to straightaway left. Pagan moves over, and that's the third out. I have to imagine there's a full moon tonight, judging by this bunch. Back with more here on a Tuesday night after this. Brandon Belt will dig in now. One home run shy of 20 for the season so far.
Number nine, Brandon Belt.
Starts him with a good rising fastball there for strike one.
You know, a lot of times with a sinker baller out there, you're just conditioned to always look for something down. So he can surprise you with that high fastball, maybe four-seam it every once in a while. And when he does, you can forget it.
Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Well, a couple of good swings back-to-back, but nothing at all to show for it.
A little bit off the outside. It's one and two. Hot shot towards the hole. And a base hit here to open up the second.
Batting pen. Shortstop.
Brandon Crawford will stand in for the first time now, hoping to break out of this little seven-game dry spell at the plate. Ball. Now a fastball, a bit too low here. It's ball one. Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. One and two now as that's in there at the knees. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Still one and two as he fouls it away. Right side hit hard. And that's through for a hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
And that's back-to-back hits now to start things out in their half of a second. They're in good shape to get on the board here and tie up the ball game.
also striding in, Matt Duffy, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Skied into straightaway right. Waiting on it, the right fielder. One down.
Batting seven, the right fielder, number six.
Settling in now, Jarrett Parker, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. First offering on its way. In there at the knees, strike one.
Pretty cool right there. You know, it's so important in a tough spot to get that first pitch strike over, and he's able to jump ahead.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Boy, things are going from bad to worse so far. He's looking completely lost up there.
Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Set to deliver on nothing in two. Here it comes. Strike three called, and now he's one out away from getting out of this.
You know, and I think most hitters will tell you, if you get a bad call on strike one or strike two, you know, they can live with that. But if you're going to punch me out on strike three, it better be a strike. If not, I feel like you're taking the bat out of my hands.
Standing in now, Angel Pagan. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing in one. We'll check in with an average still south of 230. Two home runs and 32 driven in. Dodgers have the early 1-0 advantage as we play the second. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
They were in good shape with the first two on to start the inning, but the rally's definitely stalled out from there.
Sinker misses, and it's 1-2 now.
And against a veteran hitter like this, you got to be in that strike zone early in the count, because the more pitches he sees, the better he's going to be able to time anything you've got.
Has to be thinking strikeout here. Pulled toward right center field. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Giants leave a couple. They trail this one 1-0. Adrian Gonzalez will come forward now, back in the lineup here after getting yesterday afternoon off.
Adrian Gonzalez.
First pitch coming, here it is. Chop foul at the plate, strike one. The windup and the 0-1. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. And Belt will just take this one over himself for the out. And with that, let's take a look at the Giants lineup defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. EK, what do you got?
Well, guys, over at shortstop in this one, we'll see an arm that you don't see very often. He has a cannon. He's the type of guy, he can kick a ball, boot it, still pick it up, and get the runner at first.
Into the box, Yasmani Grandal, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
You know, he's just flat out a better hitter from the left side. He's a switch hitter, but it's no secret this is his favorite side to hit from.
Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one. Bases are empty, one man out. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. chop foul right at home plate. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Bounce towards the second baseman. Throw gets him, two down.
These infielders have been busy early on, and that's another ground ball out for them. Probably not going to be the last one we see either.
Number 25 will stand in now. 0 for 4 in that day game yesterday.
Well, when you have a rough day at the plate, it's all about letting it go. You can't dwell on it for too long.
And that misses inside, 1-0.
Yeah, trying to go front door with that breaking ball. Started it a little too far inside, though.
Two out, nobody on. Sinker stays outside and is behind now 2-0.
Yeah, and he didn't even have to think twice about that one. And now he's got a good hitter's count here, 2-0.
Hit hard to short. Crawford fields it cleanly. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. We play two innings. It's 1-0. Chris Heston set to lead off the third. 9-1-2 due up.
Well, you know, it's always a tough inning when your pitcher leads off for you because most of the time the guys just flat out can't hit. But who knows? Maybe he can get something started here and help himself out.
Sends that one out of play for strike one. And he falls behind 0-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Well, it's always nice to get the inning started against the pitcher. He sets him down easily for the first out of the third.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And standing fourth is the left-handed hitting Denard Span. Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. One out, nobody on. Might have thought about it here, but he lays off the breaking ball inside. It's even at 1. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Taken high and deep to right. Right fielder looking up, still going back. Gone! A solo shot off the bat of Denard Span. 7 home runs for him on the year now, and the Giants have come back to tie things here at 1-1.
And this is just a fastball right here, but I'm pretty sure it's not where he wanted it. This has got some elevation to it, and that's one of those where you know it's going to be a home run as soon as you let go of it.
Now batting, second baseman.
Here's Joe Panik.
Panik.
Yes, he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike.
Yeah, same pitch here from the home run ball, but this one's in a much better spot down at the knees.
And here's a swing and a miss as he falls behind, nothing and two.
Boy, they're just hacking at everything. I mean everything.
Bouncer down the line. And that is off the first base bag. And they'll recover and get an out on the play. My goodness.
Number 28, Buster Posey.
Buster Posey. In now, hopped out in his first trip.
Yeah, he just uppercut a fastball. That top hand kind of dragged through the zone, which caused the bat head to drop a little bit.
First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike. You got to figure that that man right there would be more than happy to see this guy at the plate taking his swings with two out and nobody on all night long.
So would the guy on the mound.
And it's quickly 0-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. And another foul ball. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. One in the inning, and it comes from a rather unlikely power source. We played 2.5, all even at one apiece. Number 6 will get his
leading
first cuts here.
Second baseman, number 6.
And he pours this one in at the letters, 0-1. Not the greatest at bat thus far as he misses that pitch in the dirt and falls behind nothing and two now. In the dirt, but swung on and missed. And the throw is there to record the first out.
Batting ninth. Pitcher.
A reminder that Dodger 18. Baseball continues all season long here on the show. There you get a look at what's coming up over the course of the next 7 days. Number 18 stands in for the first time. Here's a slider to start things out, looked at for ball one.
That's what you have to do against a big sweeping slider like that. It starts in the zone, and it's probably going to finish out of the zone, so that's a good job just to lay off.
Bases are empty, one man out. One oh pitch is a sinker swung on and missed, 1-1.
Oh, and he sure got a good one, doesn't he? That ball goes from about knee-high to ankle-high in the matter of about 5 feet.
Looked like he was on that one, but it's 1-2. High and deep out to left center field. Back goes Span at the track, but he can't get it as it's off the wall. And he'll cruise into the bag at second with a one-out double.
How about this show of power? I think it's fair to say that this was pretty much unexpected. He nearly gets this ball out of the ballpark. Boy, I mean, where did that come from? He almost looked like he knew what he was doing.
Stepping in now, Kike Hernandez, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. A 1 count, here's the pitch. Hit to short, backhanded, on to first, and there were two down.
And that's why you love this guy playing short for
you. Now batting.
Excellent range, and he's going to show off that hose, too. That's a nice play.
Here's Howie Kendrick. As he'll take a look at a strike right down the middle, it's 0-1. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. But this will get foul for strike two. Here comes the nothing and two pitch. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. One left for LA. Through three complete, all tied one apiece. Back alongside Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, Matt Vasgersian, as it'll be Brandon Belt getting ready to lead things off here for San Francisco. And here's a ball hit in the air. Kendrick giving chase. And he set down, one away.
Now batting.
So with the fly out there coming on the fastball, seems like an appropriate time to check out our pitch speed comparison for these two starters. And both guys showing good but not great fastballs, 92 for one, 91 for the other. So one away here with the bases empty. And stepping in, the slick fielding shortstop, Brandon Crawford. And here's a ball hit in the air. Turner onto the grass. He gets there and makes a fine running play for the second out.
Yeah, it's not like he needed any help. He's pitching well enough as it is, but this is now two pitches and two outs here in the inning. And he's growing more and more confident with every passing batter.
Matt Duffy is at the plate now, flied out in his first at bat. Into the windup and the pitch. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as you'll take a look at strike one.
Oh, boy, he is attacking hitters in this one. Another first pitch strike right there, and he's up right around 90% in that category so far.
Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
And you kind of get the sense that he's not really messing around out there too much. There hasn't been a whole lot of setting guys up here in this inning. He's just trying to get himself back into that dugout as fast as he can.
Frozen on the fastball. Never had a chance, and the inning is over. Giants are down 1-2-3. On to the bottom of the fourth, tied 1-1. Corey Seager is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
And this is a guy that can make a big change in this game with one swing of the bat because you know he has big-time power.
And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing in one.
When you look at the way he's throwing the ball, he's thrown first pitch strikes to less than 40% of the batters that he's faced, and yet he's still pitching well, and we're in the middle of this ballgame.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Pagan on the run. He's there and records the first down.
Well, you know, he had the right idea up there, so at least you know he's thinking. He tried to go the other way with this ball, but he got under it just a little bit, and it's an easy play out there in left field.
Justin Turner is into the box for his second appearance, 0 for 1 with a flyout. First delivery to him on the way. First pitch sinker misses in on the hands that time. It's a ball and no strikes.
And if he can get himself into a fastball count, don't be surprised if he has a big cut at something. Maybe try and break this tie ball game.
One out, nobody on. And a breaking ball falls in there for a strike. It's 1-1.
Oh, man, he must have been looking for something else. That was a curveball that had "hit me" written all over it, and he couldn't pull the trigger.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. It swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right, and that'll get down for a base hit. Around first, on his way to second now, and he's in there safely. He's got a double.
Well, you got to start a streak somewhere, and he's well into this one now. A six-game hit streak with that base hit. He's swinging the bat pretty good right now.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Adrian Gonzalez. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time. And a pitch takes off inside, and it gets away. And he's going to make it into third base now, as I believe that'll be scored as a wild pitch.
And then just one pitch later, he basically turns a double into a triple. This is going to be scored a wild pitch right here.
Hits are now even at four apiece. Chop foul right at home plate at strike one. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Hit sharply toward the right side. In there. Base hit, and that ought to get the run in from third.
So smart here at the plate. You can see he's not trying to hit the ball out of the park. Well, there are times for that, but here he's got a guy out there on third, so this is just a short, compact swing. Just looking to get that run home. He's able to get the job done.
Here's the catcher, Yasmani Grandal. As the first pitch sinker misses to him, it's ball one. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. Not close. It's 2-0. Two sinkers down in the zone. No surprise what they're after here.
Yeah, and this guy's no dummy at the plate. He knows exactly what they're trying to do. It's not like he just fell off the turnip truck.
Curveball swung on, missed. 2-1 now.
That's a great call there on 2-0. The whole world's thinking fastball, but they dropped the hammer on him.
Two runs, five hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Now you've got a run already in, another runner on first. You got to think this has to be a fastball here.
High in the air out to center field. Span is under it. And he makes the catch for the second out.
This crowd oohs and ahs every time this guy hits a fly ball. But he didn't get all of that one, and it's pretty much a can of corn.
Number 25 will dig in. 0 for 1 in the ballgame. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Span over to his right, and that ends the inning. It's a run on two hits here for L.A. We played four full. It's the Dodgers 2 and the Giants 1. Leading off the inning, Jarrett Parker, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
And in a pretty close game so far, they'd love to see this guy get on base so they can get a rally started to get back in this thing.
Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike.
That's a pitch you have to lay off right there. That tight slider busting down and out of the zone, all that can do is tie you up.
Pretty well struck high and deep to left field. Kendrick looking up. Gone! A solo shot here to left, and the Giants have come back to knock this one up at two apiece.
Well, he'd retired five in a row until just now, but not anymore. He'd been on cruise control, but all of a sudden, one little mistake will snap you back down to earth in a hurry.
Now batting, left fielder.
Into Angel the box, Pagan. Angel Pagan. As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one.
Boy, he goes right back to that same pitch that he just gave up a home run on. Put it in another dangerous location, too. Lucky he got away with that one.
Tap fouled at home plate. Change up, called strike three as he rolls his eyes at the call, one away.
Well, after you've just given up a home run to tie the ball game, you can't afford to have a letdown. He made sure he didn't. He came back with an important strikeout, and he got the next guy.
Into the box now, Chris Heston. As the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike.
Yeah, and it seems like he kind of got away from that pitch here in the last few innings. You got to think about bringing that one right back.
Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Oh, man, what a perfect pitch right there in a perfect spot. And that's exactly how you have to attack a guy like this. He wasn't even close on that pitch.
Too high. 1-2.
Well, you know, when you're behind an account like this, it's all about changing your approach at the plate. You got to shorten up a little bit and just look to put the ball in play.
Hits are even right now at five aside. Hit to third. Turner's got it. Throw in time at first for out number two.
Center fielder number two, Denard Span.
Back to the top of the order now, and standing fourth is the left-handed hitting Denard Span. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And this is low, ball
one. 1-0.
This one's flared out toward left. Kendrick moving to his left, and that retires the shot. But bye-bye, baby, as the Giants are able to tie things up thanks to the solo dinger. Bottom of the fifth coming up, and we're deadlocked now at two apiece. Number six will dig in. 0 for 1 here in this one.
Second baseman, number six.
Halfway to 100 pitches, here it is. Tapped out in front of home. Posey gonna have to hurry, and a rather easy first out.
The batter.
Yeah, and you know, that's
number
a nice
19.
Play back there behind the plate. For a big guy, look how quickly he springs to his feet, gets rid of that mask, and then he finds the ball here to make the throw to first to get his man.
Standing in now, number 18. As the sinker to him finds the zone for strike one. Hit out toward second, fielded by Panic. Throw on to first, takes care of him. Two very quick outs to start the home fifth.
Yeah, he's able to set down his opposite number there. And I'll tell you, these two guys have pretty much matched each other pitch for pitch so far.
Kike Hernandez will dig in here. 1 for 2. He's singled and grounded out so far.
Yeah, putting the ball in play. Sometimes that's half the battle.
First pitch sinker misses in on the hands that time. It's a ball and no strikes.
Well on his way to another good inning right here, and you see the pitch count. It's not even close to being a factor just yet.
Two runs, five hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. That one will get out of play, and the count evens up with 1-1. Here it comes on 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Down the third baseline. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And the recovery is too late as he's able to beat the throw to first.
Well, you'll get another look at this. This ball's hit sharply, so it gets on him pretty quickly. They're able to knock it down, but they weren't going to have a play after that. That should go down as an infield single.
Here's Howie Kendrick, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. One pitch on its way. A little bouncer. That's a foul ball. Man at first with two out in a 2-2 ball game. Strike three on a pitch in the dirt. And he throws it away.
What is going on? Well, for this play to be successful, it almost always has to be a snap throw. And when you make a snap throw, it's going to be all arm. And he just can't put this one on his target.
Now in the box, Corey Seager. He flew out in his last at-bat. And with Adrian Gonzalez just around the corner, we'll see a lefty getting loose in the bullpen now. Hoping to keep it tied, here it comes. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one.
Number
hit hard up the middle. A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit. And the runner from third crosses the plate. And the run is in to score from second. It's 4-2.
Big at bat there. His second and third RBIs of the ball game, but more importantly, these two give him the lead.
Stepping in, Justin Turner. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Boy, he had a great at-bat last time up, and he'll look for another pitch he can drive right here.
Before the first pitch, a check at first, and he just manages to get his hand in. And another throw over, and the runner back. And there he goes towards second.
All ones that count.
And no throw, as it turns out, as he takes second with ease.
Take it and go.
So two runs on two hits, one giant error, and no one left on base. Five innings complete. It's the Dodgers 4 and the Giants 2. Joe Panik makes his way to the box to lead us off in the sixth inning.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. He continues to get ahead here. He's been in complete control.
I think you need to guard yourself from being overconfident, though. A bloop and a blast could still turn this game on its ear.
Swing and a looper to left. Kendrick is there. He's got it one away.
And all through this winning streak of theirs, we've seen some great starting pitching. And this has been another very good performance. Good enough to most likely keep that winning streak going.
Buster Posey will come forward now. He's popped out and struck out in his first two plate appearances. First pitch on its way. Ripped on the ground to first. And Gonzalez takes this one over to first himself for the out.
The first baseman.
You get a look there at his pitch breakdown so far. Well, that sinker of his is a great weapon to have, and he picked the right spot to use it there.
Brandon Belt will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in two trips thus far.
And you know, I think he's had a good approach in each of his first two at-bats. He seems to be seeing the ball well and putting some decent swings on it.
Out in front of it, strike one. The 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Froze him for strike three, and that retires the side. Giants down in order, still down by a count of 4-2. Alex Torres will come on now as he'll be appearing in his 45th game this year.
Number 67, Alex Torres.
Justin Turner will start things out for the Dodgers in their half of inning number six.
Third baseman, Justin Turner.
And that's taken for strike one.
And you know what? These days, so many guys are throwing in the high 90s. It makes those mid to low 90s guys look easy. But I'll tell you what, if he mixes his pitches well, it can still be plenty fast to have to deal with.
And boy, this at-bat is not starting off well as he's behind 0-2 now. High strikes, probably not on the docket for places he wants to be.
Yeah, I mean, it's no secret you got to keep the ball down against a team like this. If you go up every once in a while with a fastball, you'll be fine. But you're not going to last too long if you make a habit of working up there with your secondary pitches.
One and two, here it comes. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at two and two.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase. So now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
Jammed him a bit there as it's fouled at the plate. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Chopped foul at the plate, and the count holds at 2-2. Now a swing and a fly ball. And reined in, one away.
The first baseman, number 23, Adrian Gonzalez.
So one gone for Adrian Gonzalez. Is a swing and a high pop-up. Panic is there for it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
We could hear him all the way up here in the booth. Nine. Just a big old,
money.
Well, that's what pop-ups will make you do.
Yasmani Grandal will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. And he'll look at a fastball that doesn't miss by a whole lot. It's 1-0. We're in the sixth inning now of a 4-2 ball game. That evens it up 1-1. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Look out as this bat shatters on impact. Throw in time and the side is retired. Dodgers down in order, but they still lead this one 4-2. Back here at Dodger Stadium, the men in blue leading in this one as we get set to begin the seventh. But before we do, let's check out the game summary to this point. Brandon Crawford is set to get us started for the late innings of this one.
Giants. Well, it's a close ball Sharks game, but it's starting to get Brandon late, so they need to Crawford. Get at least one back here in this inning.
First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. Short, hit hard. Seager scoops it up, and the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven. So yet another strong outing for him tonight as we show you the league leaders in ERA.
He's right in there among the National League leaders, fifth best at the moment. And when you're pitching as well as he is, the scoreless innings just seem to stack up. He's got another good outing going here.
Matt Duffy stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0. Not the first time he's felt the squeeze tonight.
Yeah, he's looking in saying, what do I got to do to get a strike?
Inside, and he falls behind the hitter now, 2-0.
This is a guy whose numbers are on the rise, and this is a big reason why. Two close pitches, two good takes, and now he's in a great hitter's count, 2-0.
Some action in the Dodger bullpen now as it appears they have both a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. From the windup, the 2-0 pitch. Over the outside half, and it's 2-1.
Yeah, you know, he probably got the fastball he was looking for, but on 2-0, you can look for one pitch in one spot. And if it's not in that spot, you take it.
The 2-1 on its way. Oh, he wanted that one, but it misses for ball three. And with the tying run in the on-deck circle, the question, does he take a look at another one here?
He just might. You're still going to see a good pitch on 3-2, even if this one's a strike.
And the count will be full. Seventh inning here at the ballpark, 4-2 our score. Good battle continues as this ball's chopped foul at the plate and the count remains 3-2. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Hit hard down the right field line, but foul. Swing and a line drive. Foul. And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
One thing to keep in mind, he's due to bat third in the next half inning, so you wonder if this half inning could be the last one we see of him out there.
Jarrett Parker steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Here comes the first pitch. He'll start him with a breaking ball. Too low that time. It's ball one.
And right now, these guys just need something to break their way. A blooper, a bunt, a hit by pitch. Something to get a base runner and give that guy something else to think about out there.
Grounded to the right. Gonzalez is up with it. And he is called out at first on a close play as he just does get to the bag first and the side is retired. Giants are down 1-2-3. They trail it here 4-2. Number 25 will step in. He's 0-for-2 to this point.
Leading up for the Dodgers, right fielder, number 25.
Now some action out in the Giants' bullpen as they'll have both the left-hander and the right-hander get loose. Drilled on the ground to short. There is Crawford. Throw on to first in time, one away.
The batter, number six.
Number six stands in. Here's the first pitch to him. And that's in there for strike one. Really a good job so far by this guy out of the bullpen.
Yeah, he's come in and really put his stamp on this game. He's thrown a lot of strikes. That's what you want.
A little quick on that swing and he finds himself behind 0-2. Oh, and they pulled a string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight.
Since coming in the sixth, he's knocked down five
number
in a row,
18.
Giving him a real lift out there.
Number 18 will buy himself another at-bat, and in turn, he'll get himself a nice little ovation for the work he's turned in on the mound so far.
Well, he's been great. This is an appreciative crowd. They like what they've seen, and I don't blame them.
And he takes a pitch that's ruled a strike at the knees. Pretty liberal strike zone there. It's 0-1. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2.
Boy, when he's got that thing going good, it just takes a nosedive right at the end.
Two out, nobody on. And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2. Ready on 1-2. And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone here in the inning.
And the hope was that he would have chased one of those pitches, but now on 2-2, I don't think you fool around anymore.
A little late with the swing, but he stays alive. Still 2-2. All even at 2-2. Here it is. Fought off at the plate, and we'll do it again. And again, he's unable to keep it fair, but he's putting together quite a battle at the plate. Keeps fighting him off. The eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. Parker is over, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. Adam Liberatore will be summoned from the bullpen now as he'll take over to start inning number 8.
Adam Liberatore.
Angel Pagan will be the first one to greet him as he'll have to turn around and bat from the right side of the plate here.
Pagan.
And he starts the number 8 hitter with a strike, nothing in one. Grounded to third, gloved by Turner. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8.
Now batting.
And in a 4-2 game, time to check the numbers here. It's our starter comparison as we see how these two performances stack up against one another. Hunter Pence will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 8, Hunter Pence.
Into the seats, 0-1. Getting late, 4-2 our score as we play the 8th inning. Lifted high in the air and deep out to left field. Kendrick looks up. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. It's a solo shot here for Hunter Pence. 19th home run for him on the season as it's trimmed to a 4-3 game now.
Well, this is the chance you take when you work up in the zone like this. I mean, this is right in his happy zone, and he jumps all over it and sends it right over the wall.
Denard Span will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the 3rd inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. He's set. Here it comes. Trying to jam him with the first pitch slider, but it's in a bit too tight for ball one. Pitch to the plate is a slider for a strike, and it's all knotted up at 1-1. Drops one down here, and he'll try to beat it out. Throw not in time, and he beats it out for his third hit tonight.
I tell you, when it's done right, it looks so easy. I mean, this ball is put down almost equidistant from all three guys that had a shot at this. Perfectly done.
Joe Panik steps in with one in, one out, and one on here in the inning.
Yeah, it's been a pretty good inning here so far, so we'll see if they can scratch another run across right here.
From the belt, kicks and deals. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. Hits are even at 7 apiece. Swing and a ball chopped foul right at home plate. And a classic 0-2 pitch as the changeup misses low, and it's 1-2 now. A ball flying around the yard in this one, as you see so far there. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Hit in the air to straightaway center. Hernandez has a play. He's got it, and there are two down now.
That ball was hit well, and it might have been a different story if he pulled it. Instead, he hit it to the big part of the ballpark, and he's retired.
Buster Posey will stand in, and they've been able to hold him in check so far, 0-3 to this point.
Yeah, it's kind of surprising that he's been a non-factor in this one, usually a major force in their offense.
Pedro Baez will take over here with a runner at first and two gone in the inning.
Number 52, Pedro Baez.
From the stretch. Watches a fastball right there for strike one.
Getting that first pitch strike is so important against a guy like this. You have to be able to work ahead in the count and not let him dictate the at-bat.
Quick check on that tying run at first. And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely.
Got a pretty good lead right there.
Ready with the nothing in one pitch. And here's a ball lifted high into foul ground down the right field line. Number 25 is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. One for the Giants. Bye-bye, baby. Hunter Pence leaves the yard. On now to the bottom of inning number eight. It's the Dodgers 4 and the Giants 3. George Contos is on out of the bullpen now as he gets to work in his 60th game of the season.
George Contos.
Kike Hernandez leads it off for the boys in blue here in the eighth at Dodger Stadium. Jock Peterson is going to grab a bat here as he looks to try to set the table in the bottom of the eighth as they look for some insurance. Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. set to deliver the 0-1. Ah, he'll try to take control of the inside part of the plate with the fastball as he backs him off a bit.
You worry a little about things snowballing from here?
Well, you know, these are two teams that don't traditionally care for each other too much, so we've seen this go south before.
And that fastball's too much for him there. One and two.
Just overmatched him there.
And a good take there. Close, but it's two and two.
That's a good location for that cutter with two strikes. He's either got to take that and hope it's a ball, or he's got to foul that thing off.
Chopped foul at the plate, and we'll do it again. Sent on the ground out to second. And he's retired, one away.
Now batting, left fielder, Howie Kendrick.
Digging in, Howie Kendrick. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yep, they sent him packing last time, so maybe they have a pretty good idea of how to attack him again right here.
Kendrick waiting, now the pitch. Hit hard towards center, and that's in for his second hit of the afternoon.
And at this point, I don't think you could expect anything less than a two-hit ball game from this guy. I mean, he's been as hot as anybody lately, and he comes through again here.
Digging in now, Corey Seager, and he'll be looking to add on to his two RBIs from earlier. Throw over to first, and a dive, but he's back. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Oh, it's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? On to Belt, and they turn the double play. That ends the inning. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. Don't go anywhere. More Tuesday Night Baseball after this. Another nice evening here in L.A. as we welcome you back to Major League Baseball on the show. Jock Peterson will stay in the ballgame as he takes over in center.
Now playing center field, number 31.
Kenley Jansen is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth.
Dodgers, number 74, Kenley Jansen.
Kicking off the top of the ninth, Brandon Belt. And they'll need him to get something going here.
Well, this has been a great game so far, and they're only down by one. So getting this leadoff guy on would be huge for them.
Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike.
Yeah, showing no fear there. He put the pitch right at the letters away, but that guy didn't want any part of it.
Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit. Boy, never a dull moment with this guy on the mound.
Oh, he can sure drive you crazy at times, can he?
And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. Jansen comes set. Here's the 1-2. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. Off the plate that time and a little high. It's even at 2-2.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
in the air out to left. Kendrick waits on it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
The batter.
So the leadoff man gone to start the top of the ninth as we take a look at league saves leaders entering play.
Well, guys, he's one of the best in the league in that department right now. So he's made it really tough on the opposition out of the bullpen. Manager loves giving him the ball in tight games, so we'll see if he can add to his total right here.
Brandon Crawford comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. One of the things that makes him so tough to hit, the ability to put his pitches right on the black.
Yeah, I mean, you watch the catcher's glove on some of these, and it literally does not move. That's how good his stuff is.
Nothing in one count. Here it comes. Oh, can't spot the cutter any better than that. Nothing in two now.
And against a guy like this, you're usually only going to get one pitch to hit in that bat. Sometimes you might not even get that, so that's one he may want back.
A pause and the 0-2. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. The 0-2 home. He pulls this one into right, and that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
With some guys, it doesn't matter if it's 0-2 or 2-0. They take the same approach either way. Well, this right here is one of those guys, and he comes through from being down in the count.
Josh Reddick is into the game as a defensive replacement now as he takes over in right.
Right field, number 11. Josh Reddick.
In now, Matt Duffy. As he'll take a look at ball one. Nervous time now in that third base dugout.
Heck, nervous time up here. My heart's racing, and I'm just watching this game.
Runners on first with one down. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
In for a strike, and he jumps ahead 1-2 now.
Very patient here to start the at-bat. Maybe even a little too patient because now he's down 1-2.
Yeah, and I don't think he's going to get anything better than that to hit.
A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Kendrick will have plenty of room as he makes the catch, and there's a big out number two.
The right fielder, number 6, Jarrett Parker.
Gregor Blanco will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Number 7, Gregor Blanco.
Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. The 0-1 on its way. Now a swing, and he pops him up, and this should do it. And he'll squeeze this one for the final out, and the Dodgers will add one more to their winning streak as this ball game is over.
And at 9 games, I said this streak could go on for quite a bit longer. Sure enough, now it's up to 11. And the way they're playing, there could be no end in sight.
A tight ball game all throughout. Winds up a slim one-run victory in the end as we get you one final look at our line score. Well, you always hope to get a good outing from your starting pitcher, but this man went above and beyond in this one. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, I thought he really pitched well. He ran into a few problems here and there along the way, but aside from that, he was definitely a difference maker out there.
So that just about does it. For EK, Psycho, and the crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, get those smartphones and tablets out and head over to theshownation.com. The Dodgers win it 4-3. Good night from Los Angeles.
Here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Dodgers. 4 runs on 8 hits. No errors. They left 4 men on base. For the Giants, 3 runs on 8 hits. With 1 error, they left 5 men on base. Time of the ballgame, 3 hours and 2 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance, a sellout, 56,000. The Dodgers thank you for attending tonight's game. And as you leave Dodger Stadium, we remind you to please drive home safely.